Okay, it's been almost a year. I guess we can talk about Star Wars again. So, you remember a few months after Phantom Menace came out and we started to consider that part of what might have gone wrong there was that even though George Lucas and company had almost 20 years to ruminate on what the story of another Star Wars might be, they apparently went with something they cooked up really recently? Well, almost another 20 years later, it sounds like we're getting ready to do just that once again. Yay? In case you've been living in a galaxy far, far away yourself for the last year or so, the Walt Disney Company now owns the entirety of the Star Wars universe and put a new trilogy on the to-do list before the ink was even dry on the contract. Episode 7 went into pre-production with a screenplay by Toy Story 3 writer Michael Arndt, and may or may not have drawn from George Lucas' own secret long-term plans from years ago. Then it went out to directors, with the eventual selection being Armageddon and Gone Fishin' scribe J.J. Abrams. Then a hot property for having made a whole bunch of money off of the risky Star Trek reboot. And then things started to go wonky. Unapproved news from the mouse house is hard to come by, but rumors of script problems and production delays kicked up almost immediately. And this past November, we learned that at least part of that gossip was true. Episode 7, originally planned for Star Wars' traditional May release date, was delayed in favor of a Christmas season release, bumping the previous big holiday blockbuster planned for that date, Duncan Jones' World of Warcraft movie, to summer, so that Abrams could continue to refine the script, with Empire Strikes Back scribe Lawrence Kasdan coming aboard as a new co-writer in a naked bid to mollify fanboys. I mean, to bring that special magic that only the writer-director of Dreamcatcher can possibly bring. So what kind of story issues were causing all the trouble? We probably won't know the full story until long after the movie comes out, but over the weekend, The Hollywood Reporter published some more official-sounding-than-usual industry scuttlebutt that seemed to confirm what a lot of fansite gossip had been hearing all along, that Michael Arndt's original script and the plans for the overall sweep of the new sequel trilogy with them featured the children and or apprentices of Luke Skywalker, Han Solo, and Princess Leia as the main characters, with their older counterparts set up to appear in smaller but important swan song, last hurrah supporting roles to pass the torch and presumably give Mark Hamill, Carrie Fisher, and Harrison Ford one last huge international red carpet standing O. But Abrams, again supposedly, wanted the film to star the original three leads as the main characters, with the new blood starting out as sidekicks and taking over the lead roles in episodes 8 and 9, which, as of right now, will probably be handled by other directors. This, if true, would not be at all surprising to me, given what else has been made known. One of Disney's primary goals in the production of this movie is convincing Mark I Star Wars fans, who grew up on the series in the 80s and now overwhelmingly control the internet movie hype machine, to get on board with the "this is a return to the original trilogy" quality as a running pre-release meme. Hence Abrams publicly talking up a renewed emphasis on puppets, model effects, and shooting on old-school 35mm film instead of digital. Hence Kasdan, hell, hence Abrams himself, as anyone who watched the pretty good first hour or so of Super 8 can attest, mimicking the style of early 80s genre movies is one of Abrams' genuine technical gifts. So no, it would not surprise me at all that he'd favor postponing some or most of whatever the new beginnings or fresh character arcs the Arndt script was laying out for the next installment in favor of effectively producing a $200 million original trilogy fan film. Nor that Disney would enthusiastically go along with it, since they want the exact audience that will unironically get stoked for a $200 million original trilogy fan film to get stoked and provide them with terabyte after terabyte of free advertising. Now, speaking as a pathetic, unreconstructed Generation X man-child myself, yeah, I get why that's appealing. Just like I get still wanting an original cast Ghostbusters 3 until I, you know, think about it for a minute. Just like I got the appeal of other out-of-mothballs revivals like Blues Brothers 2000, Christmas Vacation 2, or Crystal Skull until, you know, I saw them. There's just not a great track record for these comebacks, folks. Tron Legacy is probably the best one, and I mostly liked that movie, but maybe it's the fact that this broke the same weekend that we're hearing about the WWE looking into the logistics of bringing Hulk Hogan and Rowdy Roddy Piper to WrestleMania 30 for one more legacy match. A rather more literal version of aging entertainers who should be enjoying their retirements in dignity getting dragged back out to work, in these guys' case at the very real risk of serious physical injury, in the aim of profiting from giving a nostalgia charge to a generation that just can't accept real human performers aren't ageless and eternal like comic book characters. Oh hey, Peter Parker's gonna be Spider-Man again soon, by the way. But if this is legit, this feels like potentially pissing away the running time of an entire movie on something that should maybe just be a subplot or a scene in a movie. I mean, yes, absolutely, get those three back for their one last fandom standing O. Let Han fly the Falcon and save the day again. Let Leia blow some henchmen away. Have Luke waste a whole room full of guys like it was nothing and remind everyone that he's head Jedi in charge. Give them all iconic Remember Me pop-in cameos throughout the story, and then the big last showdown show off in the inevitable action-packed finale, right before Abrams kills one of them off in order to establish the new bad guys are serious business. Oh, just watch, they'll totally do that and it'll probably be Han, remember where you heard it first. But do you really want that to be the main thrust of a whole movie? Red, but with whoever's still kicking around from Star Wars, and meanwhile the actual fresh characters and new ideas for the future of the franchise are hanging around in the background, setting up stuff that they promise will go somewhere interesting in the next one? We're really gonna spend a whole movie on, hey guys, remember that time we were in those movies? Wasn't that awesome? We're going to play it that safe, even though this movie being a hit is so much of a foregone conclusion that the premise could be that instead of killing him, Darth Sidious merely blasted Mace Windu to present-day Earth, where he has to help a group of kids save an orphanage with lemonade stand profits, and it would still make billions worldwide on the name alone? I don't know. I'm still, against my better judgment, pretty damn optimistic about a new trilogy. I think it's a good idea. I think it's the best thing that could have happened to Star Wars given the circumstances. But this smacks of the worst kind of give-the-fans-what-they-think-they-want pandering that seldom leads to anything truly worthwhile. I could be wrong. I hope I'm wrong. We'll see. I'm Bob, and that's The Big Picture.